Okay, so now that we've done that, the next thing we're going to do is muck about with bringing in background images. So I'm going to click our background resource type. We've got no background, so we'll create one. I'm going to call this Starscape. And we're going to add a frame. Choose image. I really like this paste from clipboard option, it's really cool. I'm going to add our space background, click add. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to, not just yet, but we actually have a scroll speed, so we can change its scroll speed horizontally, so it'll move horizontally or vertically. And it's important that your background is tiled or tileable. In fact, yeah, I'm going to press down and change that to about 5. Unfortunately, because Stencil's horrible in this way, it doesn't actually preview what it's like, or the actual tiling. Okay, so I'm just going to hit save again. With our background done, we're also going to bring in signs. So again, no signs, we're going to create one. One is going to be our sound or explosion. Create. And we're going to import a sound file. I really don't know why the assets say it's PNG, but whatever. Okay, 2 seconds. I have an idea. I'm going to delete that. Going to open up our folder. And I'm going to drag this in. There, that adds. Don't ask why, just is. Press play and you have earphones, you can hear the sound. And our sound type, which is pretty cool, is sound effect. Going to go back and I'm going to drag in our music. And it is sound music. Excellent. Going to exit out of that. And I'm just going to try something for the crack. Drag in a background. Yep, excellent. So a quick way of importing assets is actually to drag them in. Let's try with an actor. No, doesn't work for actors, unfortunately. But for backgrounds and sounds, you can drag files in. It's brilliant. So now we have sounds in. Now the next thing we're going to do is make a new scene. Let's call this our space. Death Star. Whatever you want to call it. Remember, as the way this works is we want it to be tiles. We'll just keep the defaults for the time being. Let's see. Solid colors, fine. I'm now going to bring in a background. So we go over to background. We're going to click the plus button. You can actually see that we have backgrounds and foregrounds, which is pretty cool. So background is what's drawn behind the scene and foreground in front. So maybe one of your backgrounds is black, or maybe it's a couple of stars. Your foreground could be a couple more stars, maybe some nebula, and they kind of work together, and they're kind of in different layers. It's pretty cool. But now, we're just going to add our background in. That should be fine. Let's go to our scene, and it's not showing up. I think we have to press a button here, which is show background. Still not seen. Let's save our game. There we go. And let's test our scene. And that's very quick. And it's going the wrong way. So go back to our dashboard, go to our backgrounds, double click our background. Change that up, change that to about 5. Test game. Excellent. So we have brought a background in and it's animated using vertical scroll speed. So far so good. Let's bring an actor in. Let's bring our ship. Whoops. Helps if I know how to use stencil. I'm just going to hold down shift so that lets me snap instead of having to use that option. So I'll snap him to about the middle. To get off that tool, I'm just going to hit space. Space will toggle these three tools. Very handy. Okay, so now we have our actor in. Let's now bring in a few enemies. So put the evil emperor Zerg in. 1, 2, 3, 4, about 5. I'm just going to turn on my grid because I was born strange. I like things to be even, well spaced. Ah, he's not in the middle. What am I going to do? I'm going to die. Okay, that'll do. Okay, excellent. I'm just going to stop there and open up a new video.